The Lord be with you.
We are glad that you're here today, whether certainly within the sanctuary here, or whether you're on Facebook Live or listening on the radio, or will see us later on YouTube. We are glad that you have joined us today as we come together to worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. I'd like to share some announcements with you. Once again, if you have any prayer requests, there are prayer request cards are located on that table right outside in the sanctuary doors. You can fill that out with any prayer requests you have and drop it in the offering plates up here or a plate outside the door. And our prayer team will take that and will certainly keep your prayer requests and your praises in their prayers. And if any of your prayer requests are confidential, just mark it as such, and we'll be sure to keep that, be sure to honor that. The Women's Bible Study is going to resume today at 5:30, Fellowship Hall, at the regular classroom at 5:30. And they're going to start a new study on Ruth entitled God's Amazing Love for You. And if you haven't already got that, just a second, I'm getting a hand signal from my better half. Okay. And, all right. You're invited to join that class today. Let's see. Okay. We want to, first of all, I wanted to announce that back on the table, right outside the sanctuary doors, beside the bulletins, there are copies of a letter there from the church leadership to the congregation. Congregation has been emailed, but if you haven't gotten that, that letter there's give you some information about the disaffiliation and our position on that. So if you haven't got an email, I encourage you to take that home with you and read it. Also, I wanted to welcome, in case you haven't noticed, the folks sitting over here to my left. I want to welcome Ben and Linda Dykstra. They are regional managers of World Renew Disaster Response Services. They're going to be leading an unmet needs assessment team here in our area for the next couple of weeks. They and their volunteers will be assisting survivors of the July 2022 flood, especially in our area and Floyd County and around. Just want to thank them. Just thank all of you for serving in this way for those who are in desperate need in our area. And thank you for serving them with the servant's heart and the love of Christ. And we thank you. Okay. Eric and our choir will lead us in our first hymn. If you would, please rise as you're able.
Soon all those around
if you'll remain standing, and invite you to join us in our affirmation of faith, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen and amen. Please be seated. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you this day in awe and praise of who you are, the God who created us and brought all things into being, the God who came to us in the flesh, in the person of Jesus the Christ, who walked this earth and showed us how to live in close communion with you, how to live your will and your ways, and who took upon himself our sins, the sins of all humankind, suffered for us, was crucified for us, died for us, and on the third day rose again for us, so that we might know of your great love for each and every one of us, as you and he sent the Holy Spirit to fill us, so that you might have a home in every heart that welcomes you. So Lord, as we gather today, we pray that our hearts and our minds would be open to you, that we would hear you speak that word that you have for each of us here. It's not by chance that we gather, but by decision and your will. And so, Lord, whether that word is a word of encouragement, hope, peace, comfort, or whether it's a word of challenge or conviction, whatever that might be, Lord, may we receive that which you have for us and respond appropriately and live out your will and your ways in our lives for our good and for the good of those around us and for the glory of your name. Lord, there's not a one of us here who have not failed you in one way or another. Even with the best of intentions, we fall short. And so, Lord, we lift up to you our prayers of confession, that we might be forgiven and restored to full fellowship with you, for that is exactly what you promised you would do. So, Lord, hear our prayers. Have mercy upon us. Forgive us and restore us so that we might walk with you anew today and every day until that day that we meet you face to face. In this world broken by sin in which we live, there's not a one of us that is not broken in one way or another. And so, Lord, for those among us who need your healing, whether it be for physical sickness or disease, whether it be for an emotional healing of the mind, whether it be relational healing for estranged or broken relationships, or whether it be spiritual healing, that we might finally turn to you or turn back to you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Whatever that brokenness may be, it could be those that are suffering some loss, and that might be a loss of a loved one or a loss of home or loss of just a loss that is impacted us or those around us. Lord, we pray for your comfort and your peace and for you to make a way forward for those of us in need so that we might know once again of your great love for each of us as your adopted sons and daughters, your children. Lord, we also want to always be aware and cognizant of the needs around us, and that we might reach out in ways that share your love and that meet people at the point of their needs. So Lord, whether that's within our community, right here in this area, or regionally, whether it's the whole world, may we be aware of the needs and respond to those in a way that blesses those who are in need and glorifies your name. Lord, we lift all these things up to you in the powerful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we offer them to you in the way he taught his disciples to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Oops. I want to invite you, to participate and to share as we continue our worship through our giving. So I invite you to bring your tithes and offerings forward and place them in the offering plate as you're led to do so. I invite you to come. Pray. Oh Lord, you give us so much. Your blessings overflow and your mercies are new each day. Lord, accept this portion of what you have given us for your kingdom. We ask for your blessing upon it so that it would be multiplied and go exactly where you want it to go and to continue the ministry of this church to this community and to all the world. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated.
Took me in, and then a little light from heaven filled my soul.
Thank you. We rarely have open confession time, but decided we would do that this morning. How many of you were tapping your toes while the choir was singing? There you go. Ah, yes. Amen. Good for you. I'm not the only one, so that's good. In a 2017 TED Talk, John Sutherland, an officer in London's police department, explained a principle in forensic science called Lucard's exchange principle, developed by Dr. Edmond Lucard, known as the Sherlock Holmes of France. This principle has a very simple premise. Every contact leaves a trace. In other words, every criminal leaves a trace behind him. One forensic expert put it this way: wherever he steps, whatever he touches, whatever he leaves, even unconsciously, will serve as a silent witness against him. Not only his fingerprints or his footprints, but his hair, the fibers from his clothes, the glass he breaks, the paint he scratches, the blood he deposits and collects. This is evidence which does not forget. Sutherland goes on to explain how this principle applies not just to forensic science, but to all human relationships. Every time two people come into contact with one another, an exchange takes place, whether between lifelong friends or passing strangers. We encourage or we ignore. We hold up a hand or withdraw it. We walk toward or we walk away. We bless or we curse. And every single contact leaves a trace. The bottom line is that the way we treat and regard one another matters. It really, really matters. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 13 through 16, Jesus tells his disciples that the content of our conversations with others matter, and the way we live our lives and where we live them matters. It really, really matters. Verses 13 through 16 of Matthew 5. Jesus tells his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth. But what good is salt if it has lost its flavor? Can you make it salty again? It will be thrown out and trampled underfoot as worthless. You are the light of the world. Like a city on a hilltop that cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your good deeds shine out for all to see, so that everyone will praise your Heavenly Father." Now, to fully understand the significance of this passage, we need to back up and look at a couple verses preceding it. In verses 11 through 12, Jesus tells us, "God blesses you when people mock you and persecute you and lie about you and say all sorts of evil things against you because you are my followers. Be happy about it. Be glad, for a great reward awaits you in heaven. And remember, the ancient prophets were persecuted in the same way. Folks, hear me on this. Followers of Jesus are living, breathing, walking testimonies of the saving, delivering, and sustaining love of God, found in a trusting, obedient, and personal relationship with His Son, Jesus the Christ, lived out in the power of the Holy Spirit. In Matthew 5:11, Jesus tells His followers, they are the salt of the earth. Now, just like the folks in Jesus' day, we know that salt preserves and flavors food. Salt is a fundamental human necessity. Without it, we simply can't survive. So when Jesus asks, what good is salt if it loses its flavor? In other words, what good is salt if it loses its essence, its essential nature of preserving and flavoring food? The answer is, it's not good for anything. Throw it away. As followers of Jesus who are supposed to be the salt of the earth, we must not lose our essential nature as disciples, living and sharing the good news of God's salvation through Jesus Christ with all people. If we don't do that, regardless of what people say about us, we are as useless to the kingdom of God as salt that has lost its essential properties of preserving and flavoring food. A city is built on a hill because it wants to be seen, not hidden. Such a city wants to have a significant and positive influence in the lives of people, and it wants to get their attention. If Jesus' followers stay in their communities of faith and fail to be seen living the good news out in the world, we are as useless to the kingdom of God as a city built in a cave whose existence is hidden from the world. Light is brought into a house, into a city, before a people, to dispel the darkness and illuminate everything, to show a way forward, to reveal the reality before it, to reveal that which is true. When Jesus' disciples go dark, when we are silent about sharing the good news with others, we are as useless to the kingdom of God as covering a lighted lamp with a thick blanket. Bottom line, the essential nature of salt is lost if it's not salty. The essential nature of a city is lost if it is hidden from sight. And the essential nature of a lamp is lost if its light is covered up. In the same way, the essential nature of a disciple is lost, Jesus says, when his followers fail to share the good news of God's saving love with those around us by the way we speak to and live our lives before others, especially when our sharing is sacrificial and costly, because such sharing shows our Heavenly Father's great love for all people. And remember, this kind of sharing has eternal consequences. And so it really, really matters. As we prepare to come to the Lord's table, remember His sacrificial love for you and be thankful. Receive the power to share Christ's love with everyone you meet. And commit to leave a trace of God's grace in every life you touch. May it be so. In your life and in mine. Christ invites to His table all who love Him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Let us confess our sin before God and each other. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we ask for Your forgiveness, for we know of Your everlasting, faithful love, and we know of Your mercies toward us. So forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory be to God. And amen. Sorry. As a forgiven and reconciled people, let us lift up our hearts and give thanks to the Lord our God. Blessed are you, O Lord, who in your Holy Spirit gathered us together, who in Jesus rescued us from sin and death, and you poured out your Holy Spirit on us, making us the people of your new covenant. On the night in which He gave Himself up for us, Jesus took the bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to His disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, He took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to His disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living offering in union with Christ's sacrifice for us. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine, so that in the eating of this bread and the drinking of this cup, we may come to know the presence of the risen Christ and be renewed as the body of Christ for the world, redeemed by Christ's blood, until Christ comes again in final victory and we feast at your heavenly table forever. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. I would invite those who are going to help us serve to come forward at this time. And as they're doing so, I want to be able to let you know that this is an open table, communion table, open for all those who are seeking, all those willing to receive Christ. So this table is for you. Remember that when Jesus invited his disciples, he invited the one who would betray him in that Last Supper. And so as we come to the table with our sins offered up to God and his forgiveness given, we can come and partake and receive that which he has for us in this meal. If you would, when you're invited, you can come down the side aisles, there'll be a team to serve you over here, Take the elements. If you'll put your hand out, they'll put the bread in your hand and offer you the cup. And after you consume the elements, feel free to take as much time as you like. You can kneel or stand in front of the altar. You can sit in the front pews. Whenever you're ready to go back to your seat, you may do so through the center aisle. And there's trays here to deposit your cups. Invite you to come, taste and see that the Lord is good. Lord, Lord, we thank you for this time around your table. And we ask, O Lord, that you would enable us to be everything that Jesus saved us for and wants us to be. Keep us faithful in these days and times as we look forward to gathering around your heavenly banquet when we can meet you face to face. We thank you for your ever faithful love and for your power to save, heal, and deliver. To you belongs all the glory. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen.
But everyone, please rise and hear it before closing.
Once again, we thank you for joining us this morning and want to offer you, as you depart, this blessing from Holy Scripture. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And all the people said, amen and amen. Go in peace. God bless you.